Good evening, everyone. Very full room, as I can see. This is my, let's say, the third instance that I have come and I'm speaking at M2. And a very good start. Thank you, Kerry, because I have seen you building content from scratch from the day one when you started M2, one content after the other. How are you guys feeling? Are you guys tired or are you guys in for a drink? It's a little Friday, as we call it. Yeah?
Let's go.
Yeah? All right. So let's get started. Content is king, everybody knows, right? I think the real question that I want to bring it up to you guys is a different question. But before that, how many of you here make your living out of content? You sell content in one form or the other. Is that it? So your business is content. So you are all competitors to me, okay? So I will keep the good bits inside me. I'll just show you the ones that you cannot use. The key question for me is not whether content is king or not, because that started, I think, a long time back when I started my career. And the question is, who is the king or queen of content? I think the key questions that we are facing is more about what is your place when so many more people can create content? What is your price, therefore, that you can charge? What is your unique advantage that you can go and sell? So I think those are the key questions we are grappling as an industry, and I think it is a bigger question than what we are seeing in Vietnam only. It is a global issue. And I'll try and show you a few examples of how I come to this thought. I'm sure everybody came across this situation last year when two students, film students, made a film for Johnny Walker, which was at a time when Johnny Walker actually changed its positioning from keep walking to joy will get you there, right? Am I right? So they thought better. They thought there was a better story to tell, and they made a story, and that made to the hearts of people more than what the brand and the agency thought was the right thing to do. And I think that's a very good example of why I'm saying all of you are my competition. Yes, I'm a communication expert, I'm a brand consultant, I'm blah, 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 but any of you can turn around my boat any day, right? Just like these two guys. One of the key things that, just keep in mind that, you know, there was a time when this happened, the brand didn't know how to respond to this whole idea of somebody coming and telling them what their brand should talk about or stand for. Anybody remembers Hijabi? No? So you remember Barbie also did a repositioning some time back, which basically wanted to represent more the diversity of women out there rather than that slim, slender, perfect, white, or whichever way beauty has always been defined, to a little more accommodating to the curves and the various ideas that beauty should represent in all forms. And somebody was enterprising enough to see the lack of reflection of herself in that idea, but some potential in that thought that she could represent herself through Barbie now. And she went ahead and put a hijab around Barbie to say that now this represents me as a Muslim woman who wears a scarf, and it's more like my doll, my idol, etc. As you can see, she started at, you know, as nothing, you know. She was a student while this happened, and she got this inspiration, this idea. She now runs a fashion boutique, if you were to like it, as well as she does these versions of Barbie dolls by herself. Imagine the heartburn to the manufacturers and the brand owners of Barbie that she is making more money out of them by using their dolls and putting a scarf around them, right? This is a challenge. This is a real challenge, right? And this is what content is capable of. And you only know what content is capable of when it hits you, like the Kendall Jenner episode recently with Pepsi. Anybody aware of that? Yeah? So that is when you realize that every post, every small little picture that you thought any freelancer or anybody in the office can mock up and put it on your Facebook, and it just hits you back, because actually that is now your 30 seconds exposure to your audience, right? It is reaching to millions of people. That is your 30-second spot, for that matter. So I think these are some examples of saying that, you know, content can come from anywhere. And so what I would like to emphasize, that we are all content creators, and I'm not exaggerating this fact. Frankly, you all have, I'm sure a lot of you have Instagram. How many of you are on Instagram? How many of you are on Facebook? LinkedIn? Pinterest? A lot of you, all of you are potential disruptors like these two people, these two guys, right? So that's why I'm saying all, we are all content creators. We are all content publishers too, yeah? And no big news there, right? We are all creative, that's the big news. And I think a lot of people feel that it's hard to call themselves creative because they are not hiding behind a title called creative director. But frankly, it is all down to that one moment when you get an inspiring thought and you come up with an idea which just strikes a chord and you are there. And a lot of people, like Pharrell Williams, had his big bash after a long time when he connected a simple song which connected to millions, right? So I think we have to acknowledge the fact that we are on platforms which are reaching a lot of people. And you have a window, you have audience, all you have to do is come up with an idea which can strike. So we are all waiting for an inspiration to strike an idea. If it becomes something, you're on it. And you own it. And I think everybody out there today is dabbling with some idea or other. I have not met anyone who doesn't have an idea what he can do besides what he is doing on his visiting card, right? So I think that's a very, very simple way of saying that today we are living in a very entrepreneurial culture and anything is possible and it doesn't cost a lot. Yeah, so that's what the competition is all about. Now, this is how it looks on the left-hand side. All of us professionals, we have so many hard, heavy, difficult words and many channels and platforms and blah, 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 right? What we are actually trying to provide and make value out of is something which is a little more organized, something a bit more meaningful and interconnected, which has some sense to it, right? When you put all these things together. So basically, we are trying to arrive at something which simplifies this whole chaos of multiple channels and multiple content potential, right? I think the key fact is that you're looking to organize things so that you can command content. And we just saw two brands failing to command content. And there are instances, more instances, where we do not have control over how the content pans out for your brand, right? But we are in that profession that we have to really have a solution, right? So we, how do we simplify that? And that's, I think, the key thing that I want to bring up today, is how do you simplify this? Some key concepts. But before we talk about that, I think we need to acknowledge that today the entire competition is this. It's a platform. Each one of you are at the same level as me. And each one of you can come up with an idea. Each one of you can go to a platform which will give you free access to thousands of people, right? Now, that completely disrupts the way we have always imagined our world, which is broken down by roles and therefore price. So in the entire content production or content creation pipeline, there is a role for a supplier and an agency or a production house and a social media guy and God knows, you know, you all know. You all know where you are sitting on that entire pipeline. The problem is, if I just cut those lines away, it all looks like a football ground where each one of you are on the ground playing against each other. Now that is the environment that we have to acknowledge is the reality, and it is not only for content, it is even for brands. That's what Uber did to all the taxi unions in any countries that it went to. Suddenly they had competition from everywhere, not from people who had money and who had, you know, reach and license, blah, blah, blah. So that disruption is the same disruption in content. And what basically it highlights is that you have to humble yourself to collaborate with people. And that's one of the things I was talking to one of our industry professionals here. We have to realize that we have to do the best of what we can do, and we have to leave the rest to the people who can do the best in the other things. And we have to collaborate. That's the only way we can put some peace and order to the whole thing. There is no way that you can crack a model otherwise. Having said that, this is what happened when Hijabi came out. A lot of people loved it, but a lot of people said that why does Barbie have to look like that? Now imagine the dilemma of the brand. Yes, a lot of people are warming up to it. Some other people are not warming up to it. Should I leave it like that? Should I comment on it? If I comment on it, what will happen? That's the dilemma, right? Having said that, we still need to figure out a way to react, to plan our actions, etc. How do we do that? That is a bigger challenge, and we'll have to figure it out by ourselves. I'm not going to try to give an answer there, but yeah, that's how it is. But you want a process, a framework, right, which simplifies this whole thing. Basically, it needs to place things in order for you to tackle, for an action when it is needed, for a reaction when it is needed, and most importantly, for measurement. And you need to put it in one funnel so that a person can see it right from top to bottom, right from that X amount of marketing dollars for that whole year, right to the like and the community, blah, blah, blah. So that is something which is not there. I don't think a lot of people have done it yet. But that's what the whole idea is. Now, like I said, currently the industry views itself as someone who can tame the lion like in a circus, you know, the master. I imagine the role that we have to play in this content chaos would be something much more like this. There's a lion in the wild, which is all these film students and you and anybody else who can come up with a beautiful, brilliant idea and can rock your boat. Can you work around that? That's the big challenge in content, yeah? I think the most important thing is for us, not for anybody else, to simplify the big picture, because we are the compass for the marketing people out there who are being hit by a Google or a Facebook or a Zalo or WhatsApp saying that, guys, we know what to do, we know who you should reach out to, blah, blah, blah. And they're like, oh yeah, you know, everybody knows, right? We all know that, you know, YouTube has as much video audience as television today, right? Yeah, YouTube can go and knock their door and talk about that, saying that, oh, I am as big as TV, you know, you need to talk to me as TV separately and I will tell you how to do things. That's not the solution. That's actually the problem. We have to realize the basics of our business and where, whether you are an agency or you are a potential Hijabi creator or the guy who wrote the film for Johnny Walker, Nivea, and actually when they wrote the film for Johnny Walker, they didn't even ask the client because the client wouldn't agree. When they did for a Volvo, the client said, yeah, go ahead with it. They cannot stop it. Anyway, so the basic is that insight into idea is equal to content. Whether it is a social post, you still need an insight. Why are you saying what you're saying on your Facebook page on that particular time of the day, during that day, every day, right? The other thing, content into channels, is interactions. And I love this fact. I was in New York a couple of weeks back, and everybody was talking about how do we classify this whole long mess of channels and blah, 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 and how do we figure out how do we deal with it. And someone came up with a brilliant idea of saying, calling it conversational interfaces. Now, that's another new word to grapple with, but I think it kind of explains all the Instagrams, Pinterest, everything which can get a reaction from people, they are conversational interfaces, as simple as that. Now you figure out which one you need, what role each of them plays, and then you figure out your strategy in there. But yes, you are after interactions. Your brand story is no more one-way street, everybody knows that, so it is content that you create, content that other people create, and the conversation that it gets in return, that's your brand story. For example, Johnny Walker, for example, Volvo, or for that matter, Barbie, right? So we have to broaden our circle, and we have to acknowledge and accept the fact that what we think is not what is going to be the end story of the brand. And I think one of the things that we need to realize is that content, we always knew content was at the center, which is why we used to make one 30-second spot and we used to call it, this is my brand, and everything else used to mirror that whole idea. Yes, but now you have to put conversation also in the center. And then there is channels around it, and every channel has a certain role to play, right from push to pull, reach to reaction. Yeah. So I think this is one way of simplifying it. You can come up with your own models, own frameworks to simplify your thinking. One of the key things that goes on is you have to know that this is not helping. This is not at all helping. All these words, all kinds of strategies, you need a strategy, period. If you are in an organized way of doing content, you need a strategy. And what does it really look like? I'll show you a little later, but I think this is the best quote that I have found from one of our fellow colleagues in the industry. I have never met him, but he makes a lot of sense. He says, content marketing isn't a replacement of other forms of marketing, which is quite opposite to how people present themselves when Google or a Facebook or anybody is knocking the door of the client saying that I am the end of it. You are not the end of it. You are actually making other forms work better. They have to have a correlation. They have to have an interlinking principle. And that is something that you need to figure out. That is something which will guide your strategy. For me, I think, for all my clients, I think this is how I approach it, and I'm happy to share it with you. Core strategy is where we need to have a complete good grip on things, on the brand. Everything, right from content strategy to social strategy to your portfolio strategy to your retail strategy, will revolve around it like planets. Your sun is the core strategy. You need to decide, you need to clarify, you need to define and then give room for it to play around that definition within the core strategy. Once you've done that, then you are in for it. Thank you so much. You have been a very patient audience. I'm sounding like a didgeridoo, but in my mind, I'm thinking I'm playing a saxophone. So sorry about my sore throat. Thank you so much for this audience.